J'aime aussi, hein. Comme ça aussi, on peut nous aimer des cadors. Monstre, Pribot Nobis, omnipotens, misericors, dormibus, Deus, que la souffle, clavis, nos. Ostende Nobis, dominum, misericors, divin, tout. Thank you.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Adoramus Deus, magnam gloriam Domine Deus, ex celestis Deus, pater omnipotens, Domine Deus, 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 Domine Deus, salus Dei, filius patris, Pitonis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, Pitonis peccata mundi, suscipe de peccationem nostrum, Sunt celest ad dexteram patris, miserere nobis, Quoniam usurus sanctus, usurus dominus, Usurus altissimus, Iesus Christus, Cum sanctu spiritu, in gloria Dei patris,
Lord, for his good. Oremus. Deus qui an sacratissimam noctem veri luminis fecist illustratione clarescere, da quesumus ut cuius lucis mysteria intera coniovimus, eius quoque gaudiis in cielo perfruamus, qui tecum vivit regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Thank you.
Translation from the Epistle of St. Paul to Titus. Dearly beloved, the grace of God, our Savior, has appeared to all men, instructing us that denying ungodliness and worldly desires, we should live soberly and justly and godly in this world, looking for the blessed hope and coming of the glory of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and might cleanse to himself a people acceptable, a pursuer of good works. These things speak and exhort in Christ Jesus our Lord. Translation from the Holy Gospel of St. Luke. At that time, there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that the world should be enrolled. This enrolling was first made by Cyrenius, the governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his espoused wife, who was with child. And it came to pass that when they were there, her days were accomplished, that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him up in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. Because there was no room for them in the inn, and they were in the same country, shepherds watching and keeping the night watch over their flock. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the brightness of God shone around them, and they feared with a great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy that shall be to all the people. For this day is born to you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord in the city of David. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly army, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of goodwill. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. In the Christmas procession, at the very beginning of the Mass, dear faithful, tonight, one of the youngest altar boys, bringing the infant Jesus figurine to the creche, said to himself, Don't drop the baby. And the priest asks himself, What is the Son of God doing in a manger? That is a question. What is this little child doing in a manger? A manger is a French word that means to eat. A child, a true God and true man, is lying in a wooden plate where animals eat. Jesus in the manger, what is he doing? He is declaring war. So humankind had broken God's plan and sold itself into slavery. In Bethlehem, Jesus is in the manger for a war. The crash, another French word, sorry for that, fulfills the plan of a dad whose children have been taken by the enemy, like a kidnapping. In the Garden of Eden, God said, I will put enmity in between you, serpent, and the woman, in between you and her offspring, and she will crush your head. It is exactly what a dad, and I know that there are many fathers among you tonight, it is exactly what a dad would say. If you don't bring my children back, I will chase you and I will not stop. I will get you down. I will fight against you. I will destroy you because I want my kids to be back home. Christmas is therefore an act of war. Humanity has been deceived and manipulated by the serpent, but humanity is not fatherless. And this is the teaching of Christmas. Humanity is not fatherless. So again, what is the baby doing in the manger? He says, I am going to fight for you. You are not fatherless. You are not abandoned. You are not worthless. Before Christmas, the incarnation of the Son of God, men hold white flags. They were defeated under the dominion of the empire of darkness. It is for this reason that the ritual of baptism starts with several exorcisms. And it is a real gift to be freed and to go back to the fatherly home. It is true liberation. When the dad knows where his children are, in a horrible place, with horrible people, in an ugly and dirty house, he knocks at the door and he tells his children, get out of here, you don't even need to pack, I bring you back home, and the monsters who detained the children for too many years are terrified because the dad imposes himself and shut their stinky toothless mouth. He reassures his children, telling them, "You will live with me and the family." That is what God is doing here in the manger. Last thing, another question. What is he doing now? Because Christmas is not only a past event. It is also what he is doing now in every tabernacle of the world. He is declaring to you, dear faithful, that you are still worth fighting for, and that God the Father will never give up. Never. This is why he's still here, to fight for you, to fight for us now. This is why you are here in the middle of the darkness of the light, of the night. It is here that Jesus, the baby of the creche, declares and leads a war against everything that enslaves us. And this is the reason for the joy of Christmas. We have been taken, kidnapped, and no matter what kind of mess or battlefield or chaos our life is, he is here as he was in the manger of the stable in Bethlehem to tell us, "Don't fear anymore, you are my child, and I will not abandon you in the hands of the enemy because I love you. In my grace and also in my arms, you are safe, and I will not drop you off because I am your father." And this is the joy of Christmas, the first communion of the world. Merry Christmas. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in nonum Deum,
Patrem omnipotentem, factorem celi et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in nomine Dominum Iesum Christum, filium Deum genitum, et ex patre natu monte omnia secula, Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vir, genitum non factum consubstantiale patri, verbum omnia fata sum, qui propter nos homines et propter nostram salutem, descendit in celis, et incarnatus est Spiritus Sanctus, Maria Virginae, Magdalena, factus est, crucifixus et siacra nobis sub Pontio Pilato, passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit tertia dies secundum scripturas, et ascendit in celis, sedet ad dextra patris, et interventus est cum gloria judicare vivos et mortuos, cuius regnum erit fius, et in spiritus sanctum dominum et ficante, qui ex patre filio conjugit, qui cum patri et filio simul adoratur et cum glorificatur, qui locutus est per prophetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confiteor in baptisma in remissionem peccator, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, vitam verbum seculi.
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Thank you. Per omnia saecula saecula.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Sum corda. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignum et justum et secum et salutare, nos tibi sempre et ubique gratias agere, Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterne Deus, quia per incarnati verbi mysterium, nova mentis nostri oculix lux tui, claritatis infulsit, ut dum visibiliter Deum cognoscim, per unc in invisibilium amorem rapiam, et ideu, cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omni militia celestis exercitus, hymnum gloriae tue canimus, sine fine dicente.
Thank you.
per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus, precepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tuum, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentation. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Tu vestri omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis vestris, perducat vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericors Domini. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tolit peccata mundi. Domine, non sum dignus ut intres sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut intres sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut intres sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea. oremus. Da nobis quesumus Domine Deus noster, ut qui nativitatem Domini nostri Iesu Christi, mysteriis nos frequentare gaudemus, dignis conversationibus ad eius mere amur pervenire consortium, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.